नमस्कार एंड हेलो, वेलकम टू श्रीदेवी क्लासेज यूट्यूब चैनल, अ चैनल डिजाइन टू इनकलकेट इंटरेस्ट एंड कॉन्फिडेंस इन साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग एजुकेशन एंड टू बिल्ड स्ट्रॉन्ग कोर कॉम्पिटेंसी विद राइट अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड क्लैरिटी ऑफ कंसेप्ट. टुडे इन आवर प्लेलिस्ट क्लास 12th फिजिक्स we will study electric field of uniformly charged insulating sphere and obtain electric field intensity and potential caused by charged sphere at its internal positions on the surface and on external positions. Let's start. Uniformly charged insulating sphere with uniform volume charge density rho as shown here is different from a conductor sphere. In conductor sphere, whether it is solid or hollow, all charge will remain only on its outer surface with identical surface charge density, whereas in insulating sphere charge is also available at internal positions. For simplicity of analysis and our studies, we'll take charge distribution in an insulating sphere all through the volume uniform, and that uniform volume charge density denoted by rho is obtained as total amount of charge on the sphere, and if sphere got a radius r, then the total volume of sphere is 4 by 3 pi r cube. So charge per unit volume or volume charge density rho can be written as 3q upon 4 pi r cube. In both conductor sphere and insulating sphere, charge produce radial electric field. Charge of uniformly charged conductor sphere on its outer surface produce radial outward electric field only to external position or on surface, whereas there is no electric field inside. But in insulating charged sphere, both internal charge and peripheral charge contribute electric field intensity, and internal electric field which is small near center increases towards periphery and exists in all internal positions except at central position. But in both insulating sphere and conductor sphere, the external electric field is identical and both charge distribution behave as concentrated point charge acting from respective centers. So for same amount of charge and radius, an insulating sphere and a conductor sphere for external observation behave in a similar manner. For all external observation points, for a distance of observation position small r from center which is greater than radius of sphere, this uniform volume charge distribution produce radial electric field. If we visualize radial electric field of inner core charge or intermediate shell charge or peripheral distributed volume charge, all force lines give a picture that they are coming from center of the sphere. So we can treat uniformly volume distributed charge similar to a conductor sphere, and in both the total charge will act like a point charge concentrated and acting from central position for all external observation positions. So for all external observations, electric field intensity and potential of spherical charge distribution is identical to electric field of a point charge acting from center. So a q charge at a distance small r from it will produce an electric field equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon q upon r square, where epsilon 0 is permittivity of surrounding media, and 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 can be treated as k or 9 into 10 to the power 9, and electric field got kq upon r square relationship. Or strength of electric field at an external position is directly proportional to total amount of charge uniformly distributed over this insulating sphere, and it is inverse of the square of the distance from central position. Similarly, potential of this uniformly charged insulating sphere is similar to a point charge, and a q charge at a distance r from it produce potential 1 upon 4 pi epsilon q upon r or kq by r, and again potential is directly proportional to total amount of charge on sphere and is inverse of the distance from center position. When we move closer to spherical surface, on the surface small r become capital R, and when we substitute this small r by capital R, electric field on the surface of uniformly charged insulating sphere comes as kq by r square, and this value is similar to surface electric field intensity of a conductor sphere on which total q charge is uniformly distributed over surface, and here this q charge is uniformly distributed over entire volume with uniform volume charge density rho. So electric field of conductor sphere and non-conductor sphere is just similar similar to a point charge acting from center, and similarly surface potential is KQ by R. In case of insulating sphere, the electric field intensity which we obtain on the surface KQ by R square, it is clear from this picture diagram also, got maximum strength over the surface. But the potential KQ by R on the surface is not the maximum, because maximum potential for this positively charged insulating sphere will occur at its center position, and this central position potential is 3 by 2 times of surface potential. A charged insulating sphere having a uniform volume charge density behave different from a conductor sphere. In conductor sphere, there is no internal source charge and there won't be any internal electric field. But in insulated sphere, charge is uniformly distributed along entire volume, and all charges, charge of internal core part within this blue spherical enclosure, intermediate shell charge of this green sphere, or peripheral charge of Schwann periphery, all produce radial electric field, and field contribution when added got minimum value near center, and this strength of electric field keep on increasing near periphery. To make our calculation simpler, for internal electric field which is not zero, we define volume charge density in this insulating charge sphere, and total charge Q is uniformly distributed in the entire volume of this sphere of radius R. So R radius sphere got volume of 4 by 3 pi R cube, and charge per unit volume or volume charge density is denoted by rho, and it can be simplified as 3Q upon 4 pi R cube. To find out electric field intensity at some intermediate position at a distance small r from center, we construct a Gaussian surface passing from observation position, and for spherical charge distribution, Gaussian surface is a common center sphere passing through observation position, and in this Gaussian spherical surface of radius r, the total amount of volume within spherical surface is 4 by 3 pi r cube, and charge per unit volume is rho, then the total amount of charge enclosed within Gaussian surface given by small q, which produce electric flux across this Gaussian surface boundary, is given by this relation when we replace charge density by 3q by 4 pi r cube, and Gaussian surface got enclosed volume of 4 by 3 pi r cube, 4, 3, pi get cancelled out, and our internal charge enclosed within Gaussian surface got a amount, total charge of spherical surface multiplied by ratio of Gaussian radius to spherical radius with cube power. So charge enclosed in Gaussian surface which produce electric flux across Gaussian surface is directly proportional to cube power of distance of observation position from center r cube. If strength of electric field or intensity of electric field over Gaussian surface is E, then elemental flux coming from elemental area ds is given by dot product of E vector and area vector, and both E vector and area vector are in the same direction. So this dot product become a simple product of E and ds. Due to symmetrical spherical charge distribution, magnitude of electric field over this entire Gaussian surface is constant, and that constant when come out of integration, we can say total flux coming from Gaussian surface is closed surface integration of surface electric field intensity. Due to symmetry, it become equal to strength of electric field on the Gaussian surface and total surface area of Gaussian surface. And as per Gauss law, it is equal to total enclosed charge within the volume of Gaussian surface divided by permittivity. As total charge Q is distributed uniformly over this entire spherical radius R, then within small r radius of Gaussian surface, charge enclosed is equal to total charge multiplied by cubic power of ratio of Gaussian radius and total spherical radius, as shown by this green highlight. Now entire Gaussian spherical surface area is 4 pi r square, and this multiplied by electric field intensity on Gaussian surface become total flux coming from Gaussian surface, and when it is equated to total charge enclosed divided by permittivity, and for calculation of electric field intensity on the internal position at a distance r from center, this 4 pi when shifted to other side become 1 upon 4 pi epsilon or k, and this r square with this r cube when simplified will produce 1 r in numerator side, and this r cube will come in the denominator side. So electric field intensity become k q upon capital R cube multiplied by small r. Here k, total charge on Gaussian surface, spherical radius, if they are all constant, electric field intensity velocity become a linear function of distance from center of the observation position, and it is also clear as radius of Gaussian surface increases, the volume of Gaussian surface increase in a cube power. So charge enclosed or the flux amount will increase in a cubic power of this distance r, and the surface area increases at a r square relation. So the flux density or the strength of electric field intensity become proportional to distance from center. So electric field intensity, which at the center for r equal to 0, if we substitute r equal to 0, is 0 at this center position. At center in 0 volume, there is no source charge, so there is no electric field. But as we move away from center towards periphery, electric force lines of inner core, intermediate shell get cumulative added up, and electric field intensity linearly increases up to periphery. And on the surface, when small r become capital R, this electric field intensity got a relation kq by r square, and this is also maximum value, and it match with external electric field, which obeys inverse square relationship. And for far away external position, when we move towards surface, electric field intensity increases and got maximum value on the surface, and this maximum value on the surface is the same for internal electric field calculation and for external electric field calculation. So there is a smooth variation in strength of electric field for uniformly charged insulating sphere. It is 0 at the center core position, increases towards periphery, got maximum value at surface, and then follow inverse square relationship and decreases as distance from center is increased. For an isolated insulating charge sphere of uniform volume charge density having total charge capital Q and spherical radius R, the potential at any point is amount of work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to that position. And for all external observations, this spherical charge distribution acts like a point charge acting from center and will have electric potential just like that of point charge Q at a distance R. And this rectangle hyperbola inverse of distance potential increases and become maximum over the surface kq by R. But for internal positions, there exists a variable electric field which got zero magnitude at central position and small magnitude near central position, and increase linearly towards surface and become maximum at the surface. So in this internal electric field, when we move its unit positive charge from surface to internal position, we have to do extra work in this variable electric field, and the total amount of work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to any internal position in the electric field becomes the potential of internal position. Now this elemental work done in movement of unit positive charge is given by relation Edr, and since radial displacement dr is opposite to direction of electric field, we have taken a negative sign, and total work done is obtained by integration. Now this integration is performed in two parts, as external electric field got inverse square relationship kq by r square just like that of point charge acting from center. So amount of work done from infinity to internal position can be calculated in two parts. Amount of work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to surface of this spherical charge is given by this integration, and this is nothing but potential of the surface, that is kq by r. And the additional work done in this internal electric field, which is a linear function of distance from center, is obtained by this integration. Here E dash is internal electric field, E dr is amount of elemental work done for element displacement dr, and total work is obtained by integration from surface to any internal position. Now internal electric field is given as k capital Q r cube multiplied by r, and when this is integrated with respect to r from surface to internal position, this kq and rq are constant, they will come out, and r got an integration formula r square by 2, and these limits of integration surface to internal position are brought in the backside of integration. So amount of work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to any internal position is potential of internal position, and it is amount of work done up to surface or surface potential plus additional work done in internal electric field from surface to internal position. And when integration is manipulated, the limits will be placed after integration formula, and once when we use final position, then this r square with negative sign is written like this, and initial position when substituted for small r variable with sign change, then that negative and negative become positive, and this result will guard got this value after substituting the limits. And here if we see first term of green highlight, then it is half kq by r, and this half kq by r added with kq by r become 3 by 2 kq by r, and the remaining term got negative sign and this value. And as we move closer to center of this insulated sphere, this term decreases, and when this difference is becoming smaller, the net result or the potential increases. That is also true that as this positive charge sphere will produce radial outward electric field, and electric field is directed from high potential to low potential. So against this electric field, when we move positive charge from surface to internal position, external agency has to do work, and work done by external agency will increase potential of charge in electric field. So potential increases, and for central position, when small r becomes 0, this potential at central position become 3 by 2 times of kq by r, and this is become the maximum potential in this charge distribution. So electric field intensity of insulated charge sphere is maximum on the surface and is equal to kq by r square, and the potential is maximum at the center position, and it is 3 by 2 times of kq by r, or 1.5 times of surface potential. For insulating sphere of uniform charge density, the field intensity at its surface is capital E, and for charge capital Q and radius r, this surface electric field E is kq by r square. We have to find out electric field intensity at internal position of center r equal to 0, at a internal distance equal to half of radius, and an external distance equal to 2 times of radius. So we know internally electric field is a linear function of distance from center, and is given by this yellow highlighted relation kq small r by capital R cube, and for center position small r is 0. So electric field is 0 at this center position, and it increases linearly for small r equal to capital R by 2. This electric field will become half of surface value. Now the surface value is given capital E. So at r by 2 distance at internal position, electric field become E by 2. So at center electric field is 0, and to the both sides as we move towards circumference, electric field linearly increases in proportional to distance from center, and at r by 2 distance electric field become half of surface value E by 2. Now for external position, this spherical charge acts like a point charge acting from its center and will follow inverse square relationship for electric field intensity, and for small r equal to 2 times of radius, the square of 2 is 4, electric field intensity become 1/4 of kq by r square, 1/4 of surface electric field intensity, or E by 4. For an insulating sphere of uniform volume charge density rho, a sphere of charge q at a radius r will produce surface potential kq by r, and that is V. We have to find out electric potential at its center and an external position which is 2 times of radius. In this positive charged sphere, internal charge distribution produce an internal electric field which linearly increases with distance from center, got smaller density of force lines at center position, and that gradually increases near surface. So when we move a positive charge against this electric field inside this sphere, we have to do work, and for stronger electric field near surface, amount of work done per unit of displacement would be higher. So rate of change of potential is higher near surface, and as we move towards center, the strength of electric field keep on decreasing as it is linearly proportional to distance from center. So in weaker electric field, when force becomes small, the amount of work done per unit charge in movement become small. So amount of change in potential decreases, and up to center position, the total amount of additional work will make potential 1.5 times of surface value. So at center position, electric potential become 3 by 2 times of surface potential. Now for external observation position, in inverse square relation of electric field intensity, the amount of potential or amount of work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to any distance position r is just like that of point charge kq by small r, and if small r is 2 times of surface radius, then the potential will become kq by 2r, that is half of surface value. Surface potential is V. So at 2r distance from center, potential will become half of surface value V by 2. We have given two insulated charge sphere isolated of radius r1 and r2, but both have same uniform volume charge density rho. For similar volume charge density, we have to find out ratio of surface electric field intensity and potential for these two spheres of radius r1 and r2. We know for surface calculation, spherical charge, whether conductor or insulating, behave like a point charge acting from center. So electric field intensity at surface is given by kq by r square, and surface potential is given as kq by r. Now in place of charge, which is not known to us, it is given that volume charge density of both spheres is same. So this charge can be replaced as volume charge density multiplied by volume of sphere. And if we simplify this relation for surface electric field, then we got ratio of rq to r square as 1r in numerator, and surface electric field become proportional to product of volume charge density and radius of sphere. Since both isolated insulator sphere got similar volume charge density, so we can say surface electric field intensity is directly proportional to radius of sphere. So for two spheres of radius r1 and r2, the ratio of surface electric field intensity e1 is to e2 is directly proportional to their radius, is equal to r1 is to r2. So if r2 is 2 times of r1, then electric field on double radius sphere is 2 times of surface electric field of smaller radius sphere, and that is true for same volume charge density. Double radius will make volume of sphere 8 times, or total amount of charge 8 times, and the radius square will make a 4 figure. So 8 by 4 become 2. So electric field intensity of 2 times radius sphere will become 2 times of other sphere. Similarly, we can calculate surface potential relation in terms of volume charge density, and total charge is charge density multiplied by volume of sphere, and when this rq is divided by this r, it will fetch a r square terms in numerator, and we can say surface potential for insulated charge sphere of volume charge density rho is directly proportional to product of rho and r square. And if surface charge density of two spheres of different radius r1 and r2 is equal, then surface potential is directly proportional to radius square. So the ratio of two surface potential v1 and v2 is equal to square of ratio of radiuses. So if r2 is 2 times of r1, then potential of bigger sphere is 4 times of potential on surface of smaller sphere. Definitely, this learning video have explained electric field of uniformly charged insulating sphere, and you have understand electric field intensity and potential of such insulating sphere at all internal and external positions. We finish our learning video here only, and again meet with a new learning video. Thank you very much.